glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Cougars of Houston, ready to launch. Everybody's getting loose. They know what type of opportunity is in front of them if they can land a victory today. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Stadium in Houston, Texas. These fans are pumped up and anxious to see this one get underway.
And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Matthew gives it at the three. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
That perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Campbell is the punter. He makes it out to midfield. Kirk, one of the top backs in the country we get a chance to see today. Mixon's big playability makes him a threat to score really anytime he touches.
I love this guy. Let's not forget about his big offensive line. This is a group that really prides themselves in opening up some huge holes for him. It's also going to be difficult to stop him and keep him out of the end zone because, you think about it, he's known for his big plays, the home run ability. So if you can limit those big plays, you got a shot at least at slowing him down.
And he gets the ball 25, 30 times a game, and he'll probably get that again today. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Nice run up the middle. Good run by the halfback. That'll be good enough to move the chains.
And that shows you why he's such a weapon as a ball carrier. Good gain for the offense. Receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Inside the 10. And they make the stop at the 3-yard line. He makes the PAT. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
Time to go to the Little Apple in Manhattan. And for Memphis, they've won two straight. Memphis takes the 7-point win. In other games, the Hawkeyes were ranked 24th. Now the loss is likely to knock them out of the poll. This one was tight. The Demon Deacons get the win, 28-21.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. The Cougars are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. They give to the tailback. He's tackled at the 27. From their own 27-yard line. Second down. Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks.
Roberts makes the tackle at the 32-yard line. That makes it 3rd and 3.
He's to the 40, and he's taken down right around the 46-yard line.
The play was very well conceived as they were able to get a decent gain and a first down.
From their own 46-yard line, first down. Dumps it out left, got the fullback.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
Made at the 33-yard line.
Parsons makes the tackle at the 31-yard line. That makes it 1st and 10.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. Tackled after positive yardage. Watson gains around 5 yards on the counter play from scrimmage.
2nd and 5.
Up the middle for a nice gain. And this is the 8th play of the drive. Taken down at the 14.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? Well, this offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their 3rd first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
Touchdown, UCF!
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he hits the PAT. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
The Horned Frogs were ranked 11th in the nation. They hope that spot proves they are capable of rising much higher. And for TCU, they've won 2 straight. And for Motley, he pitched it around for more than 250 yards. The Horned Frogs victorious by 14.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 26. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Here we go! Green up!
Tackle around the 41-yard line.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 41.
Here we go. Green 90. Green 90.
Nice run, and he's brought down. We played one quarter. We're even at 7 in this one.
Makes it 2nd and 6.
And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is
ready.
59.
Ready. Right 80. Right 80.
And he's tackled right around the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line, it's first down.
Check 59, Mike is 59,
Let's go! Green 90,
Makes it out to about the 23. First and goal from the 5. They're knocking on the door. Looks to a receiver. Touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he adds the extra point. A 6-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
McCarthy is lined up to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Inside handoff. They'll bring him down around the 26-yard line. It's 2nd down, 8 to go. Ball on the 26. Going to go across the middle, caught. And down he goes, right around the 48-yard line.
First down.
Run, Mike.
for it.
So they end up with a loss after calling the draw.
He started out rushing the passer and then just got lucky and ran right into the running back on the draw.
From their own 47-yard line, it's second down. Zips it to the tight end. Brought down at about the 49.
Number 51 on the tackle at the 49-yard line. That makes it 37.
He passes it. This one will fall incomplete. Williams is back deep to return the punt. And he's tackled at the 23.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Houston up 7 points.
Ready.
The halfback with a carry. Makes it to the 31. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. And they push him out around the 31-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He steps up, dives for extra yardage. From their own 34-yard line. Second down.
Four down. Check 59. Mike.
Let's go. Green 95. Green 95.
Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. Right around the 42-yard line.
That'll make it fourth and two.
Houston is up by a touchdown. And down he goes at the 31-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Let's go.
And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
From their own 31-yard line. Third down.
Three down. Let's go.
Fires incomplete.
Boy, that was a rocket. If the receiver didn't come down with it, quarterback made sure nobody else was going to come down with it either.
Campbell awaits the snap. Made at the 45-yard line.
Mixon's right now just having his way with this defense. And through two quarters, or most of two quarters, he's controlled the football game, and some adjustments are going to have to be made at halftime on the defensive side.
Well, the defense is going to have to do something, because if this trend continues, there's no way that this football team can come back and win the game. I look for this defense to load the line of scrimmage, just get really aggressive, take some chances. What the heck? At this point, anything's going to help their cause. So get more aggressive in the second half and see what they can do.
Fires that quickly to the tailback, and they make the stop at the 43. Houston is up seven. Pressure got to him, and he put it on the ground. They'll drop in for a loss. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. Throws it, watch out. Oh, almost had a pick.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass, because he stuck his paw right in the passing lane.
And a quick throw. Knocked out of bounds at the 23-yard line. First and 10. Ball in the 23. Fires quickly to the tight end. He's tackled at about the 13.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That can be just enough time for the quarterback.
Play to set up first and goal.
Eagle! Eagle! Here we go! Green 90! Check!
Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
And he tacks on the extra point. A seven-play, 52-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 19. Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. And he's tackled right away.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
You wonder if they'll go to the no huddle here. Not a lot of time left.
He lets it fly. And he tackles him hard at the 25. We played a half of football. Houston in front, 21-7. Hi,
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. From the 50, first down. Up the middle for a nice game. Mixon gets the call again. Gets out to around the 28. From the 28-yard line, it's first down. Taken down around the 10-yard line. First and 10, 10 yards to the end zone. Gets to about the 8-yard line.
The ball just kept scooting all over the place on the sideline, and it finally skipped out of bounds before anybody could claim it.
Here's the eighth play of the series. That That's his third toss for a score.
The one thing this quarterback does a nice job of is taking what the defense gives him. He's always looking for the open target.
He makes the PAT. Houston, kick this one off. Fielded at the four. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
The Cougars continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And that one's incomplete. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 20. Tackle made right around the 18-yard line. The 35.
This guy is one of the most reliable receivers around. They needed a big play on third down, and he got it for them.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. Quick release, tight end, incomplete. He'll get the call again. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 40.
That'll make it 35.
And so it's another third down upcoming here.
That's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
Williams is back awaiting the punt. Oh, excellent punt. Gets to about the 27-yard line. The Knights have simply rocked the college football world with an astounding effort in this one.
This is one of the biggest upsets I think we've seen all year. You know what's great? They didn't worry about any of the outside distractions. They just kind of locked in to themselves and their coaches, getting ready for this football game, and it's really paid off for them.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's taken down at the 44. The 44-yard line. First down.
Here we go. Wide 80.
They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. Complete. He's got space to work. Locked down at the 27. First
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. About 4 yards away here on third down. And down he goes, right around the 16-yard line. They're just one quarter away. Houston's got a 3-touchdown advantage. This very pivotal fourth quarter. The extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Early in the fourth quarter here, and obviously we've got a game that's a blowout. In this situation, you just want to get out of this game without getting anybody hurt.
Red, two, yellow, three.
And they make the stop at the 34-yard line.
Right, brings him down at the 34-yard line. That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. On the draw.
That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
Play action here. He's going to scramble. Sack on the play.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Campbell is the punter. He's at midfield. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Houston's proven to be the better team in every facet of this football game.
Boy, their defense has played lights out. Their offense is taking advantage of their opportunities. Everything has led them to a very comfortable lead.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Houston is winning big. Here he goes. He gets hit out of bounds at the 29.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
Gets out to about the 21-yard line.
That's a deep. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. The catch and look out, and that sets them up with a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Fights forward to about the 7.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and goal.
That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 7.
Ready! Wide 80!
And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. Mixon's confidence in a pressure situation, Herbie, and he comes through again.
Well, Brad, we've talked about this young man the entire ball game, and this is another example of what makes him so special. An opportunity to help his team late in the game, and he has a huge impact on the ball game.
And he tacks on the extra point. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
The Wolverines roll into this one ranked 8th in the land. And for Michigan, they're trying to win their first game of the year. The Wolverines have the lead, 21-0.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. McCarthy has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, late in the fourth quarter, this game has been over for a long time, and now we just want to get out of here like these two teams do. Under a minute left in the game. Caught out in the open. Knocked out of bounds at the 43.
First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 43.
Three down. Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53.
Rob. He's got the corner. He's tackled at the 46-yard line.
That'll make it second and 7.
Down, and they need to get it inside the 47. Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but this game, quite frankly, has been over for a long time, and I'm ready for it to end.
That brings us to
Cougars know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance, and really the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.